Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 68 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 114 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 115 and 116. Question 115. You have an Azure storage account named Storage One. You have an Azure App Service app named App One and an app named App Two that runs in an Azure container instance. Each app uses managed identity. You need to ensure that App One and App Two can read blobs from Storage One. The solution must meet the following requirements. Requirement number one, minimize the number of secrets used. Requirement number two, ensure that App 2 can only read from Storage One for next 30 days. What should you configure in Storage One for each app? To understand this scenario, let's go to Azure portal. We are in Azure portal now. In Azure portal, we'll go to resource group. We have created one resource group, RG1. We'll go to there. And under the RG1, we do have one storage account, which is AzureWala SA1. And we do have one app service, which is AzureWala F1. So let's understand on the app service how identity management works. So in app service, we can have identity tab. We can go to identity tab in app service. Under the identity, we can turn on the identity, system assigned identity, which is a system managed identity is restricted to one per resource and is tied to lifecycle of the resource. You can grant permission to managed identity by using Azure role based access control. The managed identity is authenticated with Azure Active Directory, so you don't have to store any credential in the code. So this is the solution where we can minimize the secret management. So we have turned on the identity on application, and now we'll go to storage account. So AzureWala SA1. Under the storage, we can go to access control tab. Under the access control, we can add a role assignment. For example, we can assign any role to test here, reader, for example, and we can select here managed identity, and the application would be available here to see. So the application would have access to this storage account without managing any secrets. This is how we can provide an application service access of storage account without managing the secret for it. So this is the one solution. So in the question, application one can be provided access to the storage account using managed identity. We can turn on the managed identity on the application, and we can provide the role assignment to the application without managing any secrets. Now for the application two, let's go back to the storage account, and we'll go to shared access signature tab. Using the shared access signature URI that grants restricted access right to Azure storage resource, you can provide a shared access signature to client who should not be trusted with your storage account key, but whom you wish to delegate access to certain storage account resource by distributing a shared access signature URI to these clients, you grant them access to a resource for a specified period of time. So for application 2, we can have this solution suitable as it has the time limitation as well. So we can define the which service that application is going to access, what are the permission, if only read permission is to be given, we can check the read one only. We can define the start and end time of the access. Therefore, shared access signature is most suitable access for the application 2, which has the time limitation, which has the permissions. Now let's discuss about access keys. Access keys authenticate your application request to digital storage account, keeps your key in secure location like Azure key vault, and replace them often. So access keys could be an answer for application 1, but here we will have to manage the keys in the application. Therefore, managed identity is much better solution, where we will not have to manage any secret of the keys. Let's go back to question. App 1, we cannot use access keys because it will increase the number of secrets being used. Therefore, this is not the correct answer. These are not applicable here. The shared access key is for time limitation and more granular, and we would have to manage the secret for this. Therefore, shared access key cannot be used. Access control with identity management can be used, where we will not have to manage any secret keys. For app 2, access key do not have capability to manage the number of days. Advanced security option is not available. Access control cannot be used with the time bound control. Therefore, shared access signature is the answer for app 2, and access control is the answer. Access control with identity is the answer for app 1. Question 116. You need to create an Azure storage account that meets the following requirements. First requirement is it should minimize the cost. Second requirement is support hot, cool, and archive block tiers. Third requirement, provide fault tolerance if disaster affects Azure region where the account resides. So it does mean that we should have primary region and the secondary region, and if there is any fault, any problem with the first primary region, then the secondary region should be available. Therefore, the redundancy requirement is GRS or Geo Redundant Storage. How should you complete the command to answer select appropriate option in answer area? And in answer area, we do have AZ storage account create, and resource group is RG1, name of storage account would be storage account 1, and kind of storage we have to select and give as answer, and SKU also we have to select and give as answer. So SKU is redundancy options, these are redundancy options, and kinds are file storage, storage, and storage v2. Let's see this kind of storage account on learn.microsoft.com, and also we'll take the help of Azure calculator as well. We are in create a storage account page. under learn.microsoft.com. So if we quickly scroll it down, we can have account types here. So the kind parameters is available here, and account type is mentioned, and the supported SKU name is also mentioned here. So in the question, we have the first value in kind is file storage. So in file storage, if we check, the supported redundancy configurations are LRS and ZRS. However, in question we are looking for regional fault tolerance, therefore we are looking for GRS. File storage would not be the correct answer. Next option given in the question is storage. So we'll go for the kind, and the storage is being used for legacy, standard, general purpose, V1 account type. So here if we see, it supports LRS, GRS and RAGRS. So it could be one option, but further we will have to see if it does support the XSTR, hot, cool and archive blob. So that we will have to check on calculator page. And the third option given is storage V2. So this is the storage V2 is being used for standard general purpose V2 type storage account. So it does support almost all the redundancy configurations. We will have to see on the pricing calculator if V2 account can support the cool, hot and archive blob XSTR. Let's go to pricing calculator, which I have already opened here, and we have selected the storage account for pricing, and under the storage account we have selected account type, which is general purpose V1, and we can see here we do not have any option available for access tier, which is the hot, cool or archive blob. So that is unavailable here. So let's see on general purpose V2. When we select the general purpose V2, we do have access tier available: hot, cool, cold and archive. The general purpose V2 account meets all the requirement of that question. The first requirement was minimize the cost. So this is with the minimum cost available in Azure storage with the regional fault tolerance. Number two requirement was support hot, cool and archive blob tiers, which are available here: hot, cool and archive blob access tiers. Third requirement was that provide fault tolerance if disaster affects the Azure region. So for that GRS we can select. So it does meet all of the requirement of the question. Let's go back to question. From learn.microsoft.com we got to understand that storage V2 and storage V1, which is general purpose storage accounts, can support standard GRS redundancy option. Therefore these two are the selected one. But further, from the Azure calculator we got to understand that access tiers, which are hot, cool and archive blob tiers, are supported by storage V2 account only and not by storage V1 account. Therefore in the kind we will select storage V2, and in SKU we will select standard GRS to fulfill above requirements. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you next video.